Let us give to Roberta Misuraca the floor for the second lecture.
Okay, guys, welcome to our second class. Today we will see a practical application of what we saw yesterday. Okay, in particular, we will analyze the causality and the correlation in the economics of migration. We will cover several topics, such as the substitution between the foreign worker and natives, the economic assimilation of migrant, the migration choice, the relation between migration and crime, between migration and voting behavior, the climate change and migration, and the migration and gender imbalance with regard to the gender gap. Okay, so for what concerning the substitution between the foreign workers and natives, so a central work in this direction.
This is one of the most famous stereotypes,
Yes,
the
yeah.
idea that migrant displaced natives.
So, okay, so the central work in this topic is the card work on the Marial Boat Lift. So this paper studies the effect of a sudden increase in the foreign labor supply in Miami on the labor market outcomes of local workers. So the Marial immigrants increased the labor supply of Miami by around
Tell
70%.
them that Cuban decided that the migrant could leave and after the frontier will be closed.
Yes.
So, se non gli spiega la storia, non esiste. In that time, the Cuban that wanted to leave left and they arrived close to Miami in the harbor of Mariel. And that's reason.
Yes. So the Marial immigrants increased the labor supply of Miami by around 7%. So they affect a narrow segment of the labor market in USA that are relatively unskilled. Consider that the Marial influx appeared to have had virtually no effect on the wages or unemployment rate of the less skilled workers. So the authors in this case suggest that the ability of the Miami labor market to absorb the Marial immigrants was due to his adjustment capacity to the past, okay? To the large waves of immigrants in the two decades in the past. Okay. Another important point in the puzzle of Marial Boat Lift is the Borges critic. So consider that Borges in 2017 he
Second,
criticized.
second. This is difficult to believe because you have a small city, Miami. You have how many are marriable people?
How many?
How many? Quanti erano?
I don't know, but very
But they
huge.
had 200,000, something
A
like
lot of people.
that arrive in a small city. It's difficult to believe that they have no effect. This is an increase in supply, that there is no effect on the wage of the low-skilled people. They are not, of course, competing with the high skill, but with the low skill, of course, if there is more people ready to work in the agriculture, more people ready to work in the construction, more people available, this is likely that the wage of this type of jobs will decline. So is the first result of CARD was exactly that there
Was
was no
that
effect.
yes, there was that there is any evidence that a sudden increase in foreign labor supply affect the labor market outcome of different subgroups of workers. So there is practically no impact. Okay, so in the puzzle, as we said, an important piece is the Borgias critic. So, Borgias strongly criticized the card work. So, Borgias does not agree with card approach. Indeed, Borgias said that card uses a broad definition of competitors in the labor market. Indeed, Borgias used a more finer, I don't know, definition of competitors to find instead an effect on the more similar natives in terms of productivity. He used, in the fact, the small group of less skilled or low-skilled workers, and the author find that the marginal immigrants are 60 pencer high school dropout. So the author find, so Borgias find, a decrease between 10 and 30% with respect to other city. Okay, so what is important here is that understand why we find different result within the same framework. So the point is that it depends of the number of observations. So to assess whether the results are robust, we have to look at the number of observations, since each statistic is robust when the number of observations increases. Okay? In this direction, other authors try to understand the Mariel Boatleaf puzzle. So Clemens and Perry and Jasenov indeed show that the main problem to find a unique result in the Mariel Boatleaf puzzle is the number of observation. They show that the number of observation is too small to get a meaningful result, since outliers might affect the estimate in any direction. Okay, so the point is that Card maybe did not consider a large sample. And
Well, they
this
cannot
is
consider a sample because they don't have the data.
yes.
So the problem, this debate, Card versus Borges, George Borges is one of the most important economists in the migration research. He wrote the first model, the first empirical analysis. There are thousands of textbooks on migration written by George Borges. But Borges is also Cuban. And is also the one who came before these Mariel Boatleaf people. And he's highly educated. And he spent all his life trying to show that there is a negative effect on the labor market. So, why Delcard, who is Nobel Prize, the last Nobel Prize in economics, made his first work comparing the effect on the city of Mariel, ma ci sono i risultati
In
dopo,
questo non ci sono i
no?
risultati.
On the city of Mariel to the other cities, Borgia chose different city. In this way, of course, he found a different result. Peri and the other, they are good friend of Card, they tried to finalize, because at the end is like a personal debate between academics. But this is very interesting for you, not leaving aside the polemic between the two, but just to say that the results depend very much how it is calculated. So there is not a result in abstract. We have to measure. So the reason why it is reported here is because each paper shows there is an interesting similarity with the German case, for instance. It is important to understand and to have the best estimate, so comparing the city of Miami with similar city, which are in the United States, that have the same trend. But this is just to say that it's not easy to find the final answer. If you take different measure, different
Yeah.
control, you can have different
Consider
results.
that in general an important result is that immigrants in general don't have any effect in the labor market in the destination country. If any, this effect regards only the specific group with which immigrant workers are direct competitors. In this case, the low skilled workers. Okay, but this is an open question still. Okay, so consider that in the puzzle, in the Mariabot leaf puzzle, we can talk about correlation but also about causality because correlation is obvious, no? But causalities, we can claim causality because we have an exogenous event such as the sudden increase of immigrant worker to the Mariabot lift. Okay,
The Maria Harbor.
the Maria
Harbor è un
Harbor.
porto.
Okay, so finally, last but not least, small samples might show noisy result even if the independent variable is uncorrelated to economic condition. Okay, another interesting topic is the economic assimilation of migrant. Okay, a very interesting studies in this topic is the immigrant assimilation in the labor market, what is missing in economic literature of the professor. So, in this work, no, it's true. In this work, sorry. The author see different several works which are divided in evaluation policy paper and descriptive paper. So the evaluation policy paper aim at uncovering the causal effect of an assimilation program on economic assimilation, while in the descriptive paper the authors show that variable that are able to explain the economic assimilation. Okay, with regard to the causal effect of the assimilation programs, consider that the assimilation programs are in general programs, in general public programs, tailored for immigrants, for specific categories of immigrant, to accelerate their economic assimilation. Another interesting study in this direction is that Sarvimaki and Amalainen that show that immigrants arrive in Finland just after a specific date in which there was assimilation program experience better labor market outcomes of immigrant arrive just before this date, because the first group in this case the treated the sorry the second group in this case the treated groups must attend an assimilation program. Okay, consider that also in this case we can claim causality because immigrant entered before the date that have similar characteristics can attend this course, and in this case we can create two different group treated versus non-treated, and as I said the effect is causal practically. Okay, in general, this paper showed that earnings of treated immigrant increased by $7,000, around $7,000.
Because the problem is that there are many assimilation programs ongoing. But given that they are ongoing, you don't know How much, what is the result? Because you have a person that is clever, that attend the course after a fantastic job. You have another person that instead is not having the same result. So with the same level of education, they have different results. So it is difficult to value a problem. So the program is wrong, you have to change the program, probably is not suited to the people. So that is the reason to why there are many studies that try to value the effect of the program. But it's not easy because you need, like an experiment, some shock, so a new law, a new program that enter in place that started functioning, and you want to understand if these people has better chance to find a job or to find than before. But you need, for instance, a 16 years old with a 16 year old of the same nationality or the same number of people, same family, now component of a family. You need a reference group which is similar. Usually you do easily this type of thing at school. You have, for instance, a high school. One group of students is attending a particular program, the other group of students is attending a different program. So the two are the same age, the same place, the same locality, and so on, but they are attending two different programs. If one are able to find more easily jobs, this is a more successful program. And for migration, this is the possibility. Try to improve and to have programs which are more suiting, more effective.
Okay, so concerning the descriptive of the economic assimilation, so as we can imagine, there are many variables that are able to affect the economic assimilation, such as years since migration, education, the number of children, and so on. So, in general, having a deep knowledge of migrant characteristics at the local level could help us to address economic assimilation issues. In this direction, another interesting work is Lee and Tall.
Listen, the word assimilation, as we know, is forget it. You cannot use. Inclusion is better. Assimilation has behind the theory that the migrant should become equal to the native.
Yes.
So the economists are not so subtle and so refining in the wording. They use assimilation, but of course they don't imply that the migrant should be equal to the native, but they just simply they could find a job, live in the city, consume, and so on. Integration is another wording. Now, also integration is not updated. We use inclusion. But the theory, the economists, which are quite good, not refined, they use assimilation, with social scientists forbidden.
Yes.
They kill you as soon as you enter, you use this word. But Roberta is an economist. She living with economists. They didn't make this introduction. But the idea is that if a foreigner is living in a country, how they enter the life in the country. So assimilation, you have one dimension. So in the wage, in the consumption of cultural good, in the voting, you have many dimensions. I think that the economy deal only with employment wage, no?
Okay, as I said, an interesting study is Lee and Tall. So this table shows the relationship between the years since migration by female and male, and the economic assimilation in Switzerland. Yes. Ok, in general we can see a strong assimilation path for women that for men in the period too.
Start for all e poi
Oh, we have
rimanere.
different period, ok? Period 1, period 2.
Ma stop in period 1.
Ok, in period 1 the length of stay has a strong effect on the economic assimilation.
Don't use assimilation,
No use
the wage,
assimilation.
unemployment, what is the variable?
Economic
Performance.
performance. Higher for men than for
Women.
female. Ok, desire, no?
But first
But in the
is
first year.
significant.
And this is significant, yeah.
First is significant. After is positive.
Okay.
The square is.
The square is negative as there is no significant for female, and also cube is positive but is indifferent, yeah. Can you? Ah, zoom, ok. Ah, ok. So, but the most important thing, in my opinion, is the first row. Okay, because you can see that in the first period, the more important impact is for male than for
Female.
female. But in the long term, in the second period, the most important impact is for female, ok?
Sorry, unfortunately, it is underlined in yellow and you don't see what is in the board. You see, the last one is 0147 and
Can
the
you
first
see?
one is 007.
No,
No, non
I
posso
tried.
vedere, se vediamo, vediamo anche noi.
Allora, vediamo
No,
se
c'è il foglio
riusciamo.
giallo sotto.
E non ci do
E
io.
non si può.
Ok, 0.072, 3 star, 0.072, ok? 0.147, 0.147,
Ma
ok,
fondamentally,
desire.
the point is that it's not significant for male,
Yes.
and it is significant because there are the three stars for female. And the total significant result for all in the second period is driven by the women.
Yes, the most important part or the all effect is driven by the female. Okay. The years since migration square and cube in reality as control to see if there are any nonlinear effect, I think.
Yes.
But in my opinion, the most important the years since migration that show that in the long period, in the long term, the length of stay is more important for the economic performance, is more important for the female than for male. Okay.
You always have years since migration linear, but you have the square because, as we said yesterday, the higher is the level of the number of years you stay. At the beginning, the wage increase, but after a while, the wage does not increase anymore. If you stay 20 years or 22, it doesn't change. The difference between if you are just arrived, if it is 5 years or 10 or 20. But it's not so important if you stay 25, 24, the result will be the same. So it is declining also the impact.
Ok, another interesting topic is the migration choice. So people decide to migrate if the gain in the host country are larger than the one in the home country. Ok? An interesting study is that Groger and Hanson that describe the correlation between migration decisions and wage gains. Ok.
We have already discussed by the migration choice, the gravity model, which I used, that
Yes.
there are these forces that attract people.
Yes. So consider that two prominent future of international labor is that the more educated people are more likely to migrate.
To my dream.
Okay, this is the, if I remember correctly, positive selection, no? And in general, more educated people are more likely to settle in the host country. Okay, this is the positive selection. Oh, in this case, from the general level, so at the aggregate level, researchers in general rely on the gravity model to understand at the aggregate level, so the bilateral movements. Yes. So, an interesting study is the role of cultural goods by Lanati and Venturini.
Well, I have not done the slide. I have done by not even by Roberta, but by another
But is
PhD
true,
student
is
that
true,
used to match my
is
work.
true, no? Okay. So in this study, the authors, through the gravity model, show a causal effect on migration choice if the export of cultural goods from a country H to a country D increase the probability to move in the exporting country. So, what's important here, however, is that we have a causal interpretation of the export of cultural goods on the migration flows. This is why, in this case, the change in export is random, okay?
Okay, let us say, you remember that we spoke about the model, no? People move because they have benefits, so the higher income in the destination country. There are costs. The costs are proxy by the distance, physical distance, linguistic distance. They are proxy also by common border, former colonies. Another cost is also the culture distance. So if you go to a country that is culturally very different from you, from yours, this is more costly. So the idea was to make the trade in the equation. You usually have also the trade, because the country, if the country trade in goods, not oil doesn't work very well, but if they trade in agriculture good, in textile good, in manufacturing good, they have links, so they know that they are the culture, a little bit of the culture of the other country. Food would be a very good proxy, but Mauro Ranati didn't want to do. And this reduced the distance, the cultural distance. And we introduced instead also the trade in cultural goods. That's mean books, movie, cinema, and so on. That reduce the cost of moving, because you know already some of the culture of the destination country through this movie, books, readings, painting, and so on. The idea was this one, that reduced the cost.
Okay, this table shows the relationship between the effort of cultural goods on migration flow. Okay, as we see, there is a positive impact. Okay, this is different model with different implementation of econometric model. I don't know if I can explain. But maybe no.
Prima e seconda, ecco cosa mi
But I imagine that this is with different control, no? I imagine. So this is without controls. This is with some control. So this is different specification of the same model that show the relationship, show the impact of cultural export on the emigration rate. So what we What we say about this model is that the
If
cultural.
Morocco export cultural good, sorry, if Spain export cultural good in Morocco or Morocco import cultural good from Spain, this will favor migration to Spain. Statistic, ordinarily square.
This is different model. So what we,
Different statistical model.
yes, what we say can be implemented through different statistical model, econometric model. For instance, a linear model, without controls, with control, maybe with other controls. This is a gravity model, maybe. And this is other type of the same category, so the same econometric model, but with different control. So this is the ordinary least squares.
Please.
These are econometric models. Okay. I don't know if I can explain
Don't
these
assist.
two. Okay. Another important category of migrant is the refugees. Okay, so an interesting study is Parson and Vezina that exploit the random displacement of Vietnamese arrived after the fall of Saigon across USA states, and they find a positive effect of forced migration on the export to Vietnam. Let's take a look.
Yes, but the fact the objective of this section is to understand the economic growth of sender-receiving
No,
countries. And this is a shock, no? Refugees.
yes, this is the shock. Indeed, indeed, here, sorry, there is a copy. Okay. Take a look at this figure. So, this figure shows the impact of Vietnamese inflow to the USA and the export to Vietnam. Consider that. So, in the moment in which the Vietnamese inflow, so where is the Vietnamese inflow? Here.
This.
So, okay. So, in the moment in which the Vietnamese inflow increased, so after the fall of Saigon, okay, the export from the USA to Vietnam.
Was kneeling.
Yes, and then take a look here. They pass from 20 billion to around 100 billion. Okay, what does it happen?
Tide assets is three.
Yeah.
Export to Vietnam in your right
So the date
assets.
is
Quindi sono.
1975.
Questi sono in Italia. Quindi sono.
Yes. Ah, ok. Ah, questo è in
Versicoli
Italia.
sotto.
Ah, ok. Ok, so what we can see is that there is a positive relationship between the Vietnamese inflow and the export to Vietnam. Why? Maybe because after the arrival.
This is just a description.
Yes, this is
The
a descriptive
point is to
statistics.
understand if there is a relationship, because you can plot on the graph the number of cats, white cats, and the number of cars, and as you know, there is no
Yes,
relationship.
this is just a
This
correlation. This
is
is not
just
causation. Yes.
not even a correlation. This is a table. This is
Yes.
descriptive table, your information. And the economy tried to build a relationship on this.
This is, as we said, this is the first step in the investigating. Okay, so now we can see that maybe there is a relationship, so there is a correlation correlation between the Vietnamese inflow to the USA and the USA export to Vietnam. Okay, maybe why? Because after the inflow of Vietnamese across the USA, there was an enclave.
Exactly. Yes, you see, if you see the two phenomena has nothing in common because one is finished, the other is starting. So if you make a correlation, they are not even the same year. So correlation don't exist because this is zero and the other start in the year 2000 when the other finish.
Yes.
So that's mean that correlation is impossible. But probably you can have an effect because you have an increase in the population because the Vietnamese
Yeah.
entered there. And in addition, and you have three waves.
There are different
Yeah.
events, no? Fall of Saigon, Saigon,
But
Vietnam.
yes, but they are all Vietnamese that entered the United States.
After
So
the three
there
other
are three
Yeah.
peaks.
Yeah.
For
Okay.
that occur for different events, the humanitarian operation program in 89, the Armenia homecoming back in 88. So these are flow, and the problem is trying to understand if this inflow of refugees, which is depending not on the American economy. It is depending on what happened in the country, so they are independent from the American economy, has an effect. These are
Yes, but
outside.
this is just a correlation. So, with regard to the causation, in this case, we can see that there is a positive effect. So, this is the number of Vietnamese, of refugees from Vietnam.
See, the number, the variable of the first column are export to Vietnam.
Yes, the dependent variable is the export to Vietnam.
And the export to the world in the first column is not affecting the
Yes.
export to Vietnam. In the second column, the same. In the third column, the same. Only in the fifth column, which is different, they have a significant number.
Because this is a different econometric model, maybe is more is
More
more
controlled.
suitable to take the effect, but it's just an econometric point of view. So the second independent variable is the logarithm of GDP of the country, and this,
Doesn't work. The
yes.
error is larger than the coefficient.
So what is important for us is the number of Vietnamese, okay, that arrive in the USA. This is a positive effect.
You don't see, but there are the stars, and the coefficient is 360.
See, 0.36, one star.
And the other is 0.15.
0.15, two stars. 0.48, two stars. And 1.38, two stars. So, what this table tells us is that the inflow of Vietnamese refugees has a positive effect in the export to Vietnam from USA in all the model. So maybe the results are robust, no? Because it's confirmed in
Also, the refugees
also the
in
specific,
1975.
yes, the specific inflow after the fall of Saigon has a positive effect, and also here.
With a very large coefficient.
Maybe the other variable are control variable, income per capita, so at individual level, the share of GDP and regional control, so West Coast, East Coast, Vabbè, the constant is the
You
value
see,
of beta
it
t.
is difficult to explain why there is this increase in export to Vietnam. You see, the traditional value doesn't show any effect because they didn't have any export before to Vietnam. Only the crisis and the inflow of refugees, Vietnamese, have an effect on this.
Yes, another interesting point that considered that the number of observation is 51,
Very small.
very small. R square is good
Very high.
enough. Yes,
It's very
it's
high
good
because it's
enough.
time series analysis.
It's good enough. As we said, the different column present different econometric model. If you are interested, you can see. You can read here. The footnote show the different model. For instance, whether without control, etc. Ok?
With instrumental variable della
Yes,
scuola.
instrumental variable. This is instrumental variable that is a variable that the researcher use to as we can see, in order to introduce an exogenous effect in their analysis, but it's too complicated. I don't know if you are interested in the instrumental variable.
Okay, we make a break now and we go on. Okay,
Comunque era giusto, vedi che c'è cosa. Ovviamente pensavo di non averlo messo. Anson, one moment.
so that we need a bit more
If you want,
convincing.
you can give me your email and I send you the paper and
No,
stuff.
non c'è il fatto, non
no. No, I think it's
No,
just
no,
a
no.
question of.
Allora, one moment. Roger and Anson.
It was just an example, because I felt left behind the.
I don't remember where it is.
Vuoi riandare sulla slide? Ma voleva che. Do you want to she repeat this for all, not for you only?
Not just meeting, I was saying that it makes sense in future slides, but say talk about saying. The slide in general. You have that.
Okay, papà.
You have that
So the
the
point.
individuals decide to make it in the game.
Yeah,
Fine.
it's very. Oh, so consider that in this paper, the author studied the correlation between and gaming. So, in general, in the international labor movements, there are two different trends. Okay? The first one is that the more educated are more likely to emigrate, and this is the positive selection. The second trend is that the more educated migrants are more likely to settle in destination country, and this is the positive sorting. Okay. Oh, in this paper, the authors show that for the selection, show that migrant. Find that the migrants that are more educated are more likely to settle in a destination country. And consider that the migrants are more educated relative to the first one. The second one is that the stock of educated migrants in the destination country increases if the earning difference between high and low skilled workers. You have to remember two points. the positive selection and the positive thought. The positive selection tells you that the is positive and fine.
And to my friend, and then they stay there for. That exactly where my question is. If it's possible that from now on you can explain sort of.
You see, the if you look at this graph figure,
mm-hmm.
this is from Groger and some people, share more educated among the population, share more educated among the migrants. As you see here, then the among the migrants there is a large share educated.
Yes. Another important point is the positive sorting. The positive sorting tell us that the relative stock from more educated migrants in a destination country is increasing in the absolute earning difference between high and low. So, what does it mean? It means that the more educated migrants are more likely to settle in the destination country mm-hmm. if the difference between the high a low-skilled worker increase. Okay.
Look at here. In the United States, you have the first educated are alone.
Mm-hmm.
Also the secondary. One in Europe is the same difference because the wage differential between the United States for highly skilled and low skilled is much higher.
Yeah. All right, so that was the request, like if she could go a bit deeper into
yes.
and explain more, like, okay, so
yes,
this, so what does it mean? That's so interesting.
But if you are interested, you can, I can send the paper if you have a time, if you want, if you have free time.
All right, I'll consider that. Thank you.
Yes, thank you. Okay, another interesting topic is the relationship between migration and crime. Sometimes public opinion tends to describe immigrants as criminals who move to host country to commit crimes. According to this view, criminal behavior is the cause and migration choice is the effect. Actually, this is not correct, no? Okay, so the positive correlation between migration and crime could explain the fact that immigrants move in a country, but not the why, but not why they move. Okay, to study the positive relationship between migration and crime, an interesting study is Mastrobuoni and Pinotti. That study, the effect of a naturalization program after the EU enlargement for Romanians and Bulgarians, for Romanians and Bulgarians on the probability to report crimes committed by immigrants from Romania and Bulgaria. Take a look at this table. Okay, allora, this table. So in the panel A, we can see the official residence in Italy. Okay, this is the date of the European enlargement. Okay, and the panel B show us the people reported by the police, so the people arrested. Okay, so in the panel A, we can see that after the European enlargement, the number of Romanians and Bulgarians increases. Okay, but
even before the announcement of the enlargement has increased the problem. The announcement is that.
But in the same period, the people arrested from Romania and the guy, the priest. So there is no connection, okay? There is no correlation between the two trends, the two effects.
But before they were illegal migrants, and so they were tested. After the enlargement, they became legal, free mobility, advanced European. So, of course, they're not arrested.
Yes. Also consider that in this case, in this figure, we can see only the legal immigrant, no? Because
here,
yes, residents and
the people report to the police in general are illegal.
Yes, but for 100 residents, so this is unfair. Yes, this is a share. If not,
to the native.
To the native, yeah. Okay, in this table, I can see the causality. So, as we can see, the difference between post and pre, so the difference is negative for economic crimes and not significant for non-economic crime. Okay, so there is no causal, there is no correlation, there is no relationship between.
We look at the first 2-3 column for economic crime, and the second 3 column they don't see very well from the past.
Okay. So on this table shows bigger the probability of non vedete. Allora, this table shows the probability of reincarceration for pardoning inmates from new European member, a candidate member country before and after the European enlargement. Okay, in the first column, we will see the economic crimes, and in the second column, the non-economic crimes. Okay. They all show the post and the pre, and this is the difference. Okay, for for economic crimes, this is the new European person, no? After the European enlargement, this is the contract, and this is the difference. What is important here is that the difference that is negative, okay?
So this is saying that before the economic crime, before the enlargement, has an effect of 0.058. It is significant because the error is small. So post-enlargement is 0.023. Immediately you see which is half. And it is significant because the error is very small. So this implies that the difference between the two is strongly significant. So this means the enlargement has reduced the economic crime from the people for the new European member citizen. That means they were mainly Bulgaria, I think. The control group doesn't show any effect. So the other has been chosen, that the pre-enlargement doesn't show any effect. This is very important because you have the people affected by the enlargement, and you see that the crime has been reduced, the economic crime, and the non-economic crime instead is not significant.
Yes. Yes, Colin.
That's mean fundamentally, people has no rights before the enlargement, and they were illegal, and they risk to be in activity which are connected with economic crime. The openness of the European Commission to the labor market to the European citizens make for them easier to find a job, easier to have rights, and they reduce the economic crime.
Yes.
So the idea is that the enlargement giving rights to people make them legal is the same for the legalization, open to them the labor market, give them the possibility to have a legal job. And, you know,
yes, also here today some people think that the new inflow of immigrants can conduct to new crimes, no? This table show us that this is not true.
No, no. It's telling us that depend on the rights. If you keep them illegally in a different situation, the risk of not having job, being obliged to survive, you can enter into criminal activities. If
yes,
instead you give them the rights, they become legal, they can access the legal labor market, and also many times with the support policy, the crime is reduced.
Is reduced, that, yes. So instead, many people think that with the new arrival in Italy,
but they are if they are illegal, the risk remain. Is the prey? The risk remain. The result are saying this. The risk remain if they are
yes,
illegal.
The risk remain, but the difference is negative.
And post is reduced, and the difference this one is negative.
Okay.
Guardalo per verticale prima che col controllo. Esattamente.
Quindi non impatta sui
crimini.
Va bene, parliamo dopo. Ok.
No,
okay.
If they are not legal, the problem is that the debate, one of the stereotypes, is migrant are part of the criminal, they increase the crime. Why we have this debate? Because the majority of the people that are in prison, in jail, are foreigner. But you have to understand if it is because they don't have means, they don't have income. So you have to understand why many, the majority of them, that have been caught illegal or doing a job to survive. So this is saying that the legalization of being becoming is reducing the weaknesses of these people by entering into labor jail.
Okay. Another interesting topic is the relation between migration and voting behavior. Okay, as we know, in recent years, a strong anti-immigration sentiment has spread in almost all Western states, pushed forward by right-wing parties, no? La Meloni, un po' di politica. So, the correlation between anti-immigration parties and the share of immigrants is one of the main topics in media coverage. So, however, it's not easy to detect the causal effect of an increase in the immigrants' share and voting behavior, since the presence of immigrants might be due to specific characteristics of the host place or of the destination country. An interesting work in this direction is Dasman et al. That study that used the variation generated by a random allocation of refugees across Danish municipality to study the causal effect on voting behavior. So take a look at this table. Okay, so this table, Alexander, can I pass? Thank you. I try to explain, but it's very complicated. This table. Okay, this table.
You see, in Genoa it's difficult to find this because you know Torino, no? There is the area of Barriera di Milano where there are much more migrants. So if you have an area with an enclave that are concentrated out there, the result can be. So in this is in Sweden or in Denmark?
I try to eliminate the yellow.
In Sweden or in Denmark?
Denmark.
In Denmark, they had a random allocation of migrants. This is one of the genius of the integration policy. The idea is that if we disperse people randomly around the land, they do not create enclave, they do not create, because if they become the majority of a section of the city, there will be the reaction, people will move to another area. So, So they dispersed people on the land, and they thought this was a way to reduce the reaction of local, but also to favor the integration of the migrants. By the way, this random allocation lasted 1 year, no more, because the poor migrants, lost in the middle of nowhere, in them, they could kill themselves. They thought it was better to stay in the country of origin. You see, and after they allows the migrant to move where they wanted, because it was compulsory, the random allocation in the land. If they put you in the middle of a valley in Piemonte, you could die there. I could die for sure. I am an urban person. I'm used to living in city. And especially if they put you far from your friends, from people with whom you share something, it is difficult to live. So, but statistically speaking, it's fantastic. You want only this because they are randomly allocated, so they can give up to the individual characteristics of the participants. Okay? So statisticians, economists, we are crazy by this.
So this table shows the allocation of refugees and voting behavior for the parliament election, because this is just
E
the
poi
panel name. No,
municipality.
in the panel too, but we don't talk
Ah,
about
va bene,
refugees.
va bene, ne parlo.
Okay, in the panel. Okay, sorry, I can read for you. Share of allocated refugees in percent of local population. Okay, and this is weighted indicator for 5% largest share of allocated refugees in percent of the local population. So this
The
table is,
panel see there are more. What does the percentage plan?
yeah, so okay, this table divide the municipality into area. Okay, the rural areas, that is the rural areas and the urban areas, because this is the indicator for 5% that has larger. Okay, it's a very complicated, so I know. Okay, in this table, the author show us that in the rural area, that is this,
The voting behavior is that the center left lost the vote and the center right
the
gained the vote.
probability to vote for anti-immigration parties
Has
is
increased.
more likely. Okay? Because the author say that maybe it's because in a rural area the person, so the contact between person are more likely.
Ma also in the urban one.
Also?
In the urban one is the same. The C, panel C is
No,
the same.
panel C, this is for largest, and this is, yes, this is similar,
Okay,
but it's,
center life is negative, so is the same.
yes, but yes, it's not exactly the same, because
But
if you, but if you take a look here, share allocated refugees in percent to a local population for the 5% largest municipality, that is
yes,
the
sure,
urban
the big
county,
city, the effect
is
is
very
negative.
negative, minus 3.787, significantly. So the author,
So the center left increase and the center right decrease in the large city, the first column and the third column, but they are not significant because the
yeah.
coefficient, the error is bigger than the coefficient. So in the large cities, the effect, there is no effect on the political parties. While in small rural area, and in this one, I don't know what is panel C in.
This is weighted, is weighted indicator for the 5% largest. So what is important here is this is the rural area, and there is a probability, a higher probability to vote for anti-immigration parties. And this is because maybe, as we said, the people are more likely to encounter other people, so the contact are more likely.
Fundamentally, the large city are more multi-ethnic,
yes.
The rural area are more homogeneous, they are all relatives, and so something new also, an Italian, also a Finnish, also everybody else, will disturb the balance that's been creating many. Yes, please.
I was asked that, can we also consider the size of the rural state smaller? So if you put a number of refugees there, then it's going to be a significant number compared
to the local population. Absolutely, absolutely. But even not only refugees, everybody is a very homogeneous area in comparison to the large city in which they are multi-ethnic. Yes.
In their urban area, so the people are more likely to have immigrant as friends or work colleagues, no? Maybe in the rural area, people are more exposed to refugees, to immigrants, no?
More exposed to different culture.
Yes.
In general, more conservative in rural area. Not
yes.
necessarily, but in general, the smaller is the city, the more the people know each other, and the more close is the environment.
Yes. So the paper concludes by showing that attitude play a key role in shaping vote for anti-immigration parties, since rural areas, as we said, are more likely to vote for anti-immigration parties without any observable reason. Okay. Another interesting topic is the relation between climate change and migration. So an important strand of the of the literature has investigated the relationship between climate change and migration. So natural disaster and climate change can lead to heterogeneous effect. So in this case, since that natural disaster, climate change as exogenous events, so in this case, we can claim causality, okay? So two interesting studies is Cattaneo and Perry and Parag and Young that show the effect of temperature in the case of Cattaneo and Perry and natural disaster in the case of Parag and Young on the probability to migrate, okay? Through an implementation of a natural experiment. Okay, take a look at this table. This is from Cattaneo and Perry, and this table show the relationship between the temperature and emigration and the probability to migrate. So here, okay, we can see, so in the column, we have the different country, okay? Middle-income country, excluding top and bottom quintile of GDP per person, and poor country, bottom quartile of GDP per person. So what is important
at
here?
The rich country.
Yes, a rich country. So what's important for here is non-OECD middle country, middle-income country, poor country, and rich country. So this table shows us that the temperature has a positive effect on the probability to migrate in the middle-income country, and this is significant.
It starts 4.523.
0.5 at 4.1. Can you read?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So 4.5, 4.1 significant, but has a negative effect, a very large negative effect, -21.5 and -15.6 on the poor country. It's strange, no? Because we, in general, we think that, so the
The migration takes place more in the quarter.
Your person that arrive in the rich country come from poor country. No,
but they know instead this is not
but
so.
In China, the public opinion
they know
think
that,
that
it's not so because the migrant need enough resources, human capital to migrate, so mobility in the low country is not affected by income. And but in the
yes.
middle income country,
the reason is that in the middle income country, so the reason is due to liquidity constraint. So in the middle income country, the people have money, no, to migrate.
Enough money to migrate.
In the poor country, no. This is the
yes,
reason,
but the temperature
according to authors.
Is the higher is the temperature, because temperature will increase, the higher will be migration from the middle income country and not from the poor one.
Yes.
So but you imagine that the poor country do not have infrastructure, a water system, streets enough to cope with the higher temperature. So the temperature has a negative effect on the life, the quality of life.
Yes, so the other independent variable are the precipitation and precipitation interacting with weight, but have no effect, as we can see this, but
has a negative effect again in the poor income country.
Yes.
And no effect on the other.
Yes. Other interesting things that we can see is in this case we have some kind of controls, no, for country of origin, for period. The number of observation is not enough with law. The R square, so we know the R square is not good, but okay, because as we say,
this is
yes,
a cross section. A cross section, you cannot expect too much in a cross section. This would be very low R square in a time series, but in a cross section, well, the variety is very large, is a good performance.
Yes. Okay. As we say, the heterogeneous effect is due to liquidity constraint. Another important thing is that the emigration from middle income country and the impossibility to migrate to low income country could worsen the economic condition in these countries. Okay. Finally, we will see the interrelation between migration and gender imbalance. Okay. In this case, the point here is to see whether the outcome gap between locals and migrants differ when there is a massive inflow or country-specific inflow, okay? An interesting study here is Bowman that show how the cultural norms of West German migrants in East Germany, are able to change toward a more gender egalitarian norms. Okay, so take a look at this table, it's more clear. So we have two tables, the table 2 and the table 3, and the table 5, about 3. So the table 2 show us the differences in post-birth employment outcome between East and West German mother in West Germany. Okay,
so after the enlargement, Germany becoming one single country, but you have East German mother and West German mother.
Yes, this table consider the difference. Okay, so we here we can see the East German migrants that migrant to the West German labor market. Okay, we have the East German mother to West German labor market. Okay, East to West. Okay, so take a look here. So this table show the panel B that is 1 year after childbirth. Okay, and the panel A that show 4 4 years after childbirth. Okay, so we have different specification from an econometric point of view. We can see different occupation, different labor market position, no? Regular employed, employed, full-time employed. The same here, regular employment, employed, full-time employed. So, what do we...
Let us show the result.
Yes, yes. What we can see here is that the East mother who migrate to West labor market present high percentage. Okay, can you see?
No.
This, no. Vorrei lavare il console.
Spira un po' più giù perché gli hai tolto la same workplace control set. Ma perché non mi inizia la piccola?
Perché la prima colonna dice semplicemente
è la dire.
Ok, allora, who migrant, the East German mother, who migrant to the West labor market.
After 1 year has regularly employed.
Yes, present. So, practically there is no difference, okay? The effect is positive after 1 year. Okay, there is no difference. So what this table tell us is that the imaging is general. So in this case, we will see the result of the assimilation of a cultural assimilation of a German mother 1 year after childbirth and 4 years after childbirth. Okay. So,
in 4 years, the regularly employed increase.
Yes, but the picture is total, no? If you see, the results are very similar, no? It's positive, positive, positive.
Yes, but the coefficient are the double.
The double, but it's positive. So, what this table tells us is that the East German mother who migrant to the West labor market don't change their cultural value, okay? The situation is very similar.
Stable,
one year after childbirth to 4 years after childbirth, okay? So the point here is to see if there is a relationship between the yes, and the cultural norm. So if there is any assimilation from the cultural point of view. In this case, there is no difference, okay? All are very stable, okay? Positive 1 year after childbirth, positive 1 year after childbirth. Here we can see the long-term migrant that is very high, yes?
We don't see anything, but...
So, it's very high, this is 0.077, so it's very high to respect to this. Okay, but the point is here all is stable. Okay, there is no negative. So you can understand me if you can see
the women in the East European East Germany were used to work. So this has no effect. The fact that they moved to the West didn't have an effect in the labor force participation. Even after 1 year and 2 years in the Eastern country, women work. Their participation in the labor market is very high, 89%. So what is showing that even if they moved, the labor force participation is the same.
Yeah. So it's more clear what I said if you see this table. This table show the same relationship, but for the West mother to migrate to the East German labor market.
Which are three? Nobody.
Ah, okay, yes, no, maybe
which is not a big phenomenon.
We can see the number here. The now, yes, see, because this is the differences, yes. Maybe. Okay, now here we can see that there is no effect. Okay, after childbirth and 1 year after childbirth and 4 years after childbirth, and in the long term, in the long term, the author tells us that is after 6 years, if I remember correctly, there is no effect. So the West mother don't change their don't change their cultural norms. Okay, I don't know if it's clear. Don't adjust their cultural norms to the East cultural norm that is more egalitarian. Incredible, but yes, is more egalitarian.
Io non ho capito.
This is the
big egalitarian.
Okay. Yeah.
How we can see this table that is egalitarian?
No, the paper tells us that it's more egalitarian in the East.
That this is just saying that the Western women going the way the East don't work.
Yes, don't work. They don't change.
They don't change the country. They don't adjust to the model of the state.
They don't try to work more because
fundamentally, each woman keep their own model of origin. So the East European women work also in the West, and the West don't work also in the East, which is very strange because in Germany, the labor force participation rate is very high also for women.
Yes. So, okay. Here you can find the result because we know that is difficult to understand. So the presence of East-West gap in employment outcome in both 4 and 1 year after childbirth. Okay, this is what is shown. So women who move from East German to West German experience higher employment rate after childbirth, but they don't change their cultural norms. Okay. Whereas East German migrants continue to adhere to the childhood culture they grew up in West German migrant, okay? And they adjust their cultural path to more egalitarian cultural environment, okay?
This is not very, the data don't show this. It is taken
okay,
from
go
the
back
paper,
to the data.
But the result doesn't show this.
So,
but it's simply, they're just saying that...
So, the data show that I want to... So, consider, for instance, who arrived, no? 1 year after childbirth, okay?
In the second column, they work.
Also here?
We don't see...
Okay.
There.
Okay, work. This is same local labor market, okay?
Yes.
This is same workplace, okay. They work. Mm-hmm. After, 1 year after childbirth, practically, there is no S.
Same
no
workplace.
There is no difference.
There is just a control more fixed, further fixed effect. The only different control from this one and this,
and
one,
this one
is that the firm fixed. If you don't have a firm fixed effect, probably they have changed firm and they work in another place.
Yes. And in the long term, there is no effect. The author tells us that this result tells us that the West mother who migrated to East labor market adjust their cultural environment.
They say so, but it is not clear from the data that they did say.
So,
by
estimate,
what they say, critics, you put not what they say.
But indeed, I say that estimates are a little bit noisy, but the authors provide a set of robustness check to provide that result. Okay. This is a paper, guys. Okay, that's all. If you have any question or doubt.
Is there any section that we have done in this today that we want to revise? He was asking before about one of the paper. You see, this is not requested. This is just an introduction to help you to read the result that I show you when we do each section. The migration choice we have done already with individual data, with macro data, so the and we are redoing CAR, the issue of the marigold people, but also other system of studying the effect on in the labor market of working with the other stereotypes, welfare, use of welfare state, and so on.